characters and getting into their space. And it's not how you yourself would react to conflict, but how would they react? How would they feel, you know? So the only way to really know that is, like you said, to really truly empathize with them, is to separate the barriers between. And that kind of goes more with what we should, or we try to do as humans, to really understand each other and what kind of is lost in the current climate, where there's this huge divide. The media just is pushing people apart. The politicians are pushing people into their various camps rather than bringing them together. Even with the COVID, you have people who are for masks, and you have people against. It's always this, you know, either you're with me or you're against me. There's less empathy, you know? So I think that's important, and yeah. Artists are championing that message.
Let me share you something about writing. As someone who's been doing this for a while and publishing books. And the good things about books is that they are immortal, not like us, right? As you're saying, so the books can be real vampires, and they live eternally. So if you are writing a book, do it because you love the art and the story you are writing. And don't think that much about the audience. So write in the way you feel you should write. And if you feel your story is a long format, do it in a long format. If you feel your story lives in a shorter format, do it as it should. But do it because the story is pushing you to do it that way, not because of the audience. Because the beautiful thing about books is that we are here in 2020, but my book will still be here in 500 years. So this trend of today might be different in 50 years, and I don't know. So don't do it because of trends or because of the market we are living now, but do it because you actually love the art and you have something to share with the world.
That is some good advice, and that's something I continue to struggle with, balancing, you know, because I always have that motive of how people will they receive it, will they get value from it, you know. It's hard to be nowadays more so an artist who really puts their own will forward, you know, unfiltered, you know, and just believes in that and just creates, because we're so much looking for approval from people, you know. And like you said, if it's marketing, you know, and so I do want to do that. And then, but you know, it's something that I feel like I have to build that trust in myself. Like you said, you were able to do it. And I applaud you for that. And I'm still getting there in a way, you know, I don't know. It's a lot of balance between the two.
And the other thing, Darcis, is that's the following step is how to put it into, how to make it accessible to people. That comes after. Okay. Yeah. So first step is, if I'm feeling something inside of me, just like you felt the vampire Darcis being born inside of you when you decided to leave it, and then the rest you find out as you go along. But with books, and I totally agree with that. I actually have been in some meetings with writers, and I'm one of the younger writers in my editor, in my publisher. So I usually meet with older writers, and they complain a lot about people are not reading, and these young people are not reading books. Yeah. And what I usually tell them is that, no, people are actually reading. And I believe people are actually reading more these days than maybe 20 or 50 years, because more people know how to actually read.
That's
but
true.
people are reading in a different format. People like reading quotes, people like sharing sentences, quotes, memes, nice stories on WhatsApp and on Instagram. And people are always sharing ideas and quotes and sentences. So people still cherish and still feel pleasure by reading a good story, by nice words, nice ideas. But what I'm doing now as a writer is that instead of